In my personal experience of university, the way I started to learn about cultures was before I was a Christian. I was studying anthropology at university, which is the study of cultures. So I got into this that way. Then when I went to Christian university later, I thought, wow, now I'm going to get some biblical teaching about culture. What I found to my shock was in that university, in a master's program, they were teaching the same stuff I had learned about culture 15 years earlier. It was totally from the anthropological scientific standpoint, and this was supposed to be a Christian university. Well, as I really started to think about culture and nations and what that means, then I started to get the idea that the New Testament can be looked at as a book of cross-cultural relationships and cross-cultural communications. But my dear professors in my Christian university weren't going to the New Testament as a source of what to think about culture. So now whenever I look at the form which describes a new U of N course, or whenever I visit a course, or I'm trying to find out from students what's going on in a course, I listen for two things. One is that there's a biblical basis for what we're teaching. The second thing I listen for, which is very close, is the nature and character of God. Because everything that's in the book is based on the person of God. Jesus is the Word. So if it's not in God, then it's not going to be in the book, and why are we studying it? So my ideal for the University of the Nations, and I think our commission, and the thing that makes us, that gives us the possibility of being really unique, is that we need to recombine, revelation and reason. We need to be using our minds to the fullest, because God gave us those minds, and He wants us to use them. And for some of us, we haven't learned how to do that yet. And we need to be applying our minds to studying the best of what science and the current culture can teach us. But we also need to be hearing from God, and we need to be knowing what God says in His Word, but also minute by minute, even in the classroom. Now, we do this already in YWAM, but we have tended to separate out our times of hearing from God and our times of studying and using our mind. And we're trying to bring those closer together, but it's really difficult because we have been taught for several centuries in the Western world to keep those things apart. Revelation is for Sunday morning. It's for your quiet time. It's for your prayer group. That's the time and place for revelation. And what I'm saying is no. Every minute, every second of the day is a time for revelation. God wants to speak to us much more than we want to listen. What's the point? The point is, He knows more about any area of life that we're interested in than we can possibly ever imagine. And He is by nature a communicator. He is by nature a being who wants to share His heart with us. He is by nature a teacher, and He wants to be our teacher. If we'll open up to hearing from Him, and at the same time hearing from Him by using our minds, putting this together, then we will have fantastic learning experiences in the University of the Nations. How exactly do you do that? I don't know. But we are learning together. We're getting closer and closer to this new recombination, this new unity of revelation and reason. And that's exciting.